Fellow Montanans, we are at a pivotal moment in history. Here at home and all across Europe, economies are struggling under mounting debt. The world is watching to see what America will do. So it's up to us to show the world that America can rise to this challenge and lead by example. And that's what we're trying to do in the Debt Committee. We're meeting day in, day out, burning the midnight oil to find solutions to get our debt under control. As I'm working, I'm fueled by the words of Montanans who have told me over and over again, Max, get it done. Get it done in a balanced and right way, but get it done. There's no doubt that getting it done will include serious spending cuts. It won't be easy. And a balanced solution should also include revenue measures to make sure everyone is chipping in their fair share. And as we examine spending on the committee, we think about it in two categories. The first is called mandatory spending. As the name suggests, mandatory really means programs that are required by law, like Medicare. That's called mandatory spending. The second category, which I want to talk about more today, is called discretionary spending. Discretionary spending is the money we choose to spend on additional priorities from year to year. Discretionary spending includes important programs for Montana like highway construction, Forest Service, but more than half of discretionary spending is for defense. And a big chunk of that half goes toward the wars in Iraq and Afghanistan. It's the 10th anniversary of the war in Afghanistan. As we take stock of the challenges we face here at home a decade later, we can't ignore the role that war spending has played in our budget crisis. I salute our men and women in uniform and their families, especially the brave Montanans who have volunteered for service at greater rates than anywhere else in the country. And because of their sacrifices, Osama bin Laden is dead and Al-Qaeda is on the run. Our American military is the best in the world, but it can't do everything. We're stretched too thin. It's time for Afghan forces to take responsibility for their own country. It's time to bring our troops home and focus on building a stronger future here in America. Several of you have shared this same concern with me in your letters and during our teletown hall. Today, even our military leaders tell us that the biggest threat to our national security is here at home. The former chairman of the Joint Chiefs of Staff, Admiral Mike Mullen, said it, and I quote him, he said, "Our national debt is our biggest national security threat." Our national debt is our biggest national security threat. So when our military leaders speak, we should listen. We spend more on military spending now than at any other time since World War II, including the peak of the Cold War and the wars in Korea and Vietnam. Congress has approved more than $1.2 trillion for Iraq and Afghanistan. All that's deficit spending. And that's not just military operations, it also includes reconstruction and foreign aid. We have borrowed money from China to build up Iraq and Afghanistan. And while our infrastructure and economy are suffering here at home, that is just not right. To put this into perspective, $1.2 trillion could double the number of public elementary schools in our entire country. It could build the United States interstate highway system we have today five times over. And $1.2 trillion is enough to meet the obligations of the Debt Reduction Committee. Our troops have done an amazing job over the past decade. Thanks to their efforts, our world is now much safer than it was 10 years ago. And we will never forget the price our troops have paid while fighting for their country, especially the thousands who have given the ultimate sacrifice. We must remain vigilant in fighting terrorism. We've also got to heed the words of Admiral Mullen and be just as vigilant to get our debt under control. When it comes to national nation building, it's time to focus on America. It's time to bring our troops home and make this century the American century.